Hi everyone, this is Hridya Ramesh from Government Ayurveda College, Trivandrum. Today we are going to learn about Amla Rasa. In the previous session, we learned about introduction to Shat Rasa, Madhura Rasa and the role of proteins, carbohydrates and fats in this chapter. In this module, we are going to learn about Amla Rasa and its applied aspects and the importance of probiotics in our diet. It is also mentioned in the 26th chapter of Charaka Samhita Sutrasthana, Atreya Bhadrakapiya Adhyaya. So remembering my teachers, I'd like to start. Amla Rasa is the second strongest rasa of the six. If you remember, it was Agneya or Vidahi as I mentioned in the last session. That is, it has the predominance of Agni. Amla Rasa is actually a slight variant of Madhura Rasa, which had the predominance of Prithvi and Jala. Here, it has Agni along with Prithvi. Some other acharyas also say that it has predominance of Agni and Jala. But right now we will go according to what Vaghada Acharya has mentioned. You must note that Amla Rasa Dravyas are acidic in pH. So, let us classify Amla Rasa or sour substances that we come across. These are of two categories. The first is those which are naturally sour. Now these are Amla or Indian gooseberry, citrus fruits like lemon, pomegranate, mangoes, particularly unripe mangoes, kokum or vrikshamla, silver, etc. The second category of Amla Rasa Dravyas are those which are made sour, or in other words, which are fermented. By fermentation, alcohol or acids produced from starch and sugar act as natural preservatives. Fermentation also promotes the growth of beneficial bacteria. We'll talk about these a while later. Common examples that we come across are bread, cheese, alcohol, ketchup, soy sauce, dosa, idli, appam, dhoklas, sour pickles, and of course our very own takra or buttermilk. Now do remember that a majority of these are not solely Amla Rasa. Most of these are Amla Madhura combinations. Takra is Amla Kashaya in Rasa. Now we move on to the Lakshanas of Amla Rasa. Amlaha Kshalayate Mukha Harshino Roma Dantana Akshi Bhruva Nikochanaha. Amla Rasa removes the coating in the mouth and the coating in the teeth, and thus it leaves a cleansing effect. Also, you would have noticed how you get horripilations or goosebumps when you have something very sour, and there is sudden involuntary contraction of your eyes and eyebrows. So the Lakshanas of Amla Rasa are as simple as that. Now, we move on to the Karma of Amla Rasa. Amlo Agni Deeptikrit Snikto Hrudya Pajana Rojanaha Ushna Virya Himas Parsha Prinano Bhedano Laghu Karoti Kabhapittasram Moodha Vata Anulomanam. Amla Rasa is Snigdha and Laghu in Guna. It is Rojana or increases the taste of the food. Amla Rasa Dravyas are Deepana and Pajana. Now remember that every drug that is Deepana need not be Pajana and vice versa. Actually Deepana Pajana is a very vast concept, but right now I'll just brief it. Deepana drugs help in stimulating or kindling the Agni, which converts food in the form of energy and is responsible for metabolism and all vital functions of the body. So the normalcy of Agni is very important. If it becomes weak or manda, the food that we eat will not be absorbed properly. So if someone has manda Agni or weak Agni, whatever he eats will not be utilized by the body, even if it is taken in very large quantities, because most of it will be excreted as it is. So here he needs Agni Deepana. Now consider the situation where your body is not able to break down the food that you have taken. Here catabolism or constructive metabolism is not working well. Here you give him Pajana drugs. Consider the example of soups, tomato soups. When it is taken, it can help in good appetite and whatever you eat will be easily absorbed. It is Pajana and Deepana. So Amla Rasa Dravyas are Deepana and Pajana. It is good for the heart, or it is Hridya, and also pomegranates are proven to be very effective in cardiac ailments. Bhedana, in simple terms, it helps in the downward movement and evacuation of malas. Now these may be baddha or abaddha. That is, the stools can be tight or loose. It is not the same as virejana, as virejana evacuates liquefied malas. Ushna virya and himasparsha. It is due to this himasparsha or cold touch that we feel the roma harshana or goosebumps when we eat something very sour. So when we drink a glass of lime, we have a cooling touch, but it leaves an ushnatva to the body. This is due to the ushna virya. The ushna virya also gives amlarasa its strava or secretory guna. Now this secretion also includes the secretion in your mouth in the form of saliva when you eat something very sour or even think about it. When we have wounds or skin conditions which are oozing, we are advised to avoid amlarasa to prevent further secretion or strava. Note that dadima and amalaki are shita indriya and are exceptions. We must also note that properties like deepana, pachana, ushna virya, etc. are due to the agni mahabhuta predominance in amlarasa. As it promotes digestion and proper formation of ahara, it also nourishes rasadhatu. Karoti kabha pittasram. Amlarasa dissolutes and increases the quantity of kabha or is responsible for kabha vilayana due to the association of ushna and snigdha attributes. A classic example is that of vriksha amla, which is known as kokum in the north and kodampuli in Kerala. It is highly beneficial in obesity. Here, vilayana of medhas, which is a form of hardened kabha, takes place. Amlarasa has properties similar to pitta and therefore increases pitta. It also increases rakta. This is evident when there is raktashaya, as there is a craving for amlarasa. A perfect example for this is during pregnancy. Due to reduction in blood volume, there is increased craving for amlarasa during pregnancy. Due to its snigdha and ushna properties, it decreases vata dosha. So these are the effects of amlarasa on doshas, dhatus and malas. Amlarasa does mudha vata anulomana. Now what is mudha vata? When vayu gets stuck somewhere and is unable to do its functions, it is called mudha vata. Here, if you give an anulomana dravya, it helps in releasing this mudha vata and bringing it back to track. Since mudha vata affects the supply of digested ahara to dhatus in the body, when it is normalized by anulomya, there is enhanced circulation of nutrients and thus there is preenana of the body. Now let us see what happens due to the excess use of amlarasa. So atyabhyastastano kuryat shaithilya timiram bhramam. It causes slackness or laxity of the body. Timira here means diminished vision. Bhrama meaning giddiness. It also gives rise to a lot of diseases like Kandu Pandutva Visarpa, Shobha Visphoda Tripjaran. We know that amlarasa increases rakta. So in excess, it leads to rakta kopa and even rakta dushti and many diseases as a result of that. As you may remember, amlarasa dravyas are acidic in pH. So when excessive acidity is formed in the body, to neutralize it, bases need to be added. So bases like bicarbonates are utilized from the bones and this leads to degeneration of the bones. So if someone suffers from joint pain, which is due to bone degeneration, he will not find permanent relief if he continues to have pickles, alcohol or other fermented foods. So even if he has the best of the medicines, he needs to avoid naturally occurring sour substances as well as fermented foods. And this is the importance of patya. Amlarasa has a lot of applications in diseases like grahini. The use of tatra needs special mention here. The beneficial bacteria produced, as I told before, are called probiotics.
Probiotics are highly useful in digestion and absorption, heart health, immune functions and diseases like IBS. Most of these are those which we have already discussed. Are you able to find the link?
Amlarasa dravyas are used to create this probiotic environment which is required. And undoubtedly, the best fermented product and the richest source of probiotics which has been in use since decades and centuries is our takra or buttermilk. Quite an underrated foodstuff, isn't it? So this marks the importance of our traditional diet. So friends, do explore more about amlarasa, fermented foods and probiotics. And let us know your doubts and suggestions in the comment section. So if you found this video informative, do like, share and subscribe. So until next time, bye-bye.